west with the first expedition, carrying out her mother's grand plan, making sacrifice after sacrifice on the altar of progress. President Strand told the people what they wanted to hear and did what she thought had to be done. Also, America could be whole again. But I'm starting to wonder if it didn't cost her her soul. The Chiral Network is our greatest creation, our proudest achievement, and our guiltiest sin. I don't know how to feel about it all. Maybe if we knew more about Cliff and the BB experiments, we'd be better placed to judge. I'll be in touch. It's made you anemic. Perform a blood transfusion or get some rest before you drop.
It's okay.
ID. Clear.
Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure.
Construction
all clear. Welcome.
Sam Bridges, good to see you, man.
Oh. Sam, you know, you're just about the only thing we've got to smile about these days.
Guess I'll be seeing you around then.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information. Weapons restrictions lifted.
Please don't take me away.
Hey, Sam, I see you're coming up on Lake Nah. Stay strong. We're all rooting for you to finish the job and come home safe. By the way, I've made more progress in a certain investigation. It seems that Clifford Unger willingly put his own child in the care of the scientists conducting the BP experiments. But he did so completely unaware of their true intentions. This is pure speculation, but I think when Cliff found out about their plans, he attempted to reclaim custody. And after he failed, the BB remained in the program's care. In which case, he would have every reason to bear a grudge towards the president, the woman who allowed it all to happen, don't you think? But just because President Strand is dead, doesn't mean his hate died with her. No, I think he redirected it towards Bridges, towards you and Amelie and anyone close to the director. And now that hate is driving him to set in motion the last stranding, to bring an end to the world as we know it. Why else would Cliff hold Amelie hostage on the beach? He must know that she's an EE. There's no time to lose. You have to save her, and the director. Though I still don't understand how he managed to travel to her beach in the first place. There must be more to their relationship. I'll see what I can find.
Thank you. Deploying autonomous.
This particular type of armor can provide full body protection. It can be worn on the shoulders and legs, and the more pieces you equip, the greater the cumulative effect. However, it requires power to function, so don't let your batteries run dry.
Construction complete. Okay.
Sam, it's about the director. So there's no way he could have made the jump to Amelie's Beach if they didn't share a strong personal connection, right? Well, I looked, and I couldn't see one. The network should have contained something, anything, but there was nothing whatsoever. His entire life prior to his tenure with Bridges has been redacted. His name, his past, everything. There's no telling who he was. Which led me to consider another possibility. What if it isn't the director and Amelie who have a connection, but the director and Clifford Unger? And what if that connection is what facilitated the director's jump to Amelie's Beach? If it's those two who have a personal history, then it might explain why Cliff is holding the director hostage as well. But even if that were the case, it doesn't answer the bigger question. How the hell did the two of them end up on Amelie's Beach?
Sam, Hartman here. There's something else I'd like you to consider. A guess, albeit an educated one, concerning Cliff's objective. Somehow, with the aid of the chiral network, our individual beaches have begun to coalesce, resulting in the formation of a single, massive seam. Should this process continue, there is a risk that BTs will flood across into our world, bringing about a Death Stranding on a heretofore unprecedented scale. Now, Clifford Unger's battlefields and my own beach appear to be unaffected by this phenomenon, existing entirely in isolation. They do not and have never intersected with others. But what if there were another class of beach, one that exists on a higher plane, that was responsible for setting this process in motion? And what if the beach in question were none other than Armelie's? Cliff may have summoned the director, but I believe his true aim was to seize control of Armelie's beach, to exploit its power over every other beach, and trigger the last stranding. It's the only rational explanation for Cliff's actions, which is why you have to stop him.
If Hartman's right, then we're in serious trouble. Using the chiral network in Amelie's beach to trigger the last stranding? That's why Higgs went after Amelie, wasn't it? If it was Cliff who put him up to it. Yeah, it all fits. With the last stranding, he'll finally have his revenge against the world that stole his life and his child. You've got to stop him, Sam. You've got to make the jump to Amelie's beach as soon as possible. Get in and get her back. It's our only hope. If you can't, then we're all doomed.
John, shoot him! Where's my baby? Tango. My name is Clifford Unger. Where's my baby? I just want you to be happy.
We need reinforcements.
Move.
Where are you, baby? want you to be happy.
Eliminate him.
Light him up.
Keep your eyes.
We need reinforcements.
Move.
Cover.
Enemy target.
We need reinforcements!
Forward!
Ugh!
idea to make. I will.
Ugh!